By now, you understand a lot about how the different types of memory work and what's required for adults to learn new information. Maybe you've even started thinking about ways to adhere to these protocols and ways that you could change your learning process to maximize your success. One such strategy is an important practice called dual coding. Remember how we learned that the brain has different buffers for working memory depending on the type of information it's interacting with? Well, in dual coding, we try to get different types of working memory buffers to activate at once, thereby increasing the chances of retention and storage in long-term memory. In the coming lectures, we're going to emphasize how important it is to look at a text or a piece of information from different angles, to ask different types of questions, and to use different senses such as vision and smell, or even emotion, to engage with the material in different ways than you normally would. And this is why. This is also why we advocate a style of learning that I like to call brute force learning. This is a term that has been lifted from hacking, where a hacker will attack a server by trying thousands or even tens of thousands of passwords in the same form rapidly, often with a few different machines or different angles. What does this have to do with learning, though? Well, as we've just established, the most successful learners attack a piece of material from many angles and perspectives. They read about it, they check out contrasting opinions about it from different sources, they jot down some notes, they teach a few friends about it, they try it out themselves, they look at pictures. You get the idea. All of these different approaches and methods reinforce the learning, connecting it to other types of memories, such as experiential memories, and overall, they strengthen the neural network associated with what you're trying to learn. My point is that if you want to learn effectively, at some point, you'll need to get your nose out of the book and engage with the material in different ways, from different angles that appeal to you, and apply to the material at hand. A great example of this, by the way, would be to try and explain to some of your friends what you learned in the last few lectures about your memory and about chunking. By teaching this information, you force your brain to look at it from a different angle, to deconstruct it, to form it into your own words, and then to present it in a compelling way. As they say, something once taught is something twice learned, and we would absolutely love to see you get out there and share what you've learned with your friends so far. Since you, as an adult learner, need to be self-directed and make decisions about your experience in order to learn effectively, we'll leave a lot of this stuff up to you, though in the coming chapters, we will give you lots of different exercises to choose from and ensure that your learning is very multidimensional.